to conduct a lecture for the refresher course, ayan, of Rayo CPA Review. So, ayan, magandang gabi. So, tonight, we will discuss intellectual property law. So, I don't know if I'm supposed to start already or if there is an introduction. So, kung meron mo na admin dito or anything, you can interrupt me bago ako mag-start. Meron ba? Start na. Okay, ayan pala si Sir Rex. Okay, sige. Pwedeng pa ano, pa-enable ng screen sharing. Thank you so much. Ayan. Wait for a while. Ayan. Okay, so hopefully you can see my screen. All right. So like what I said, we will discuss intellectual property law tonight. So medyo mahaba siya, but it's an interesting topic. So I really find intellectual property law interesting, and it's something that really keeps my mind thinking na, oh nga, no? And when you encounter, you know, logos, trademarks, and when you consume a product, makakonnect niyo intellectual property law. So my goal for tonight is to make you enjoy intellectual property law as much as I enjoy it. So it's possible to enjoy a subject, diba? It's possible to have fun learning. Okay, sige. So without further introduction and any other catchosan from my end, okay, we will start intellectual property law. All right, so I have 2 hours tonight to discuss to you copyright, trademark, and patent. Okay, so first things first, let's define intellectual property. Okay, where's my pen? All right, okay. So when we say intellectual property, this pertains to intangible assets that results from the creative work of the mind. Okay, so it's a creation of the mind. So it can either be inventions, it can either be literary and artistic works, it can also be symbols, it can also be images and designs that are used in commerce. Okay, when we say intellectual property, it also pertains to the legal rights that came from those creative works, okay? Such as those that came from the industrial, scientific, literary, and artistic fields. Okay, so yan ang intellectual property, okay? So bakit kailangan meron tayong intellectual property law? What is the purpose? What is the legal basis? Okay, our legal basis for that is actually the Constitution itself. So the Constitution provides that the state should protect and secure the exclusive rights of scientists, the inventors, the artists, okay, especially if they are beneficial to the people. Okay, so the idea is to encourage more inventors, to encourage more artists, to encourage more scientists to, you know, produce more creative and artistic works, to produce more inventions in order to benefit the people. So in exchange for the benefit that is given by those inventions, in exchange for the entertainment that is being given to us by these literary and artistic works, the state in exchange gives some sort of protection. Okay, so in a nutshell, ganun yung pinaka-purpose ng intellectual property code. Okay, so nag-i-invent ka, or may mga trademark ka, meron kang creations of the mind, meron kang design, meron kang artistic works. So since nagbe-benefit ang public from that, ipoprotektahan ka namin, but you know, you continue sharing whatever you invented and whatever you designed to the public in exchange for that protection. Okay? So as to coverage of intellectual property rights, it actually comprises a lot of different kinds of intellectual property rights. But for purposes of CPA board exams, we will only discuss copyright, trademarks, and patents. Okay, so yung ibang nakikita nyo dyan na intellectual property, okay, hindi na siya part ng inyong coverage. So, wag na nating i-discuss kasi ano, baka maano lang kayo, ma-information overload. Okay, so focus tayo sa copyright, sa trademarks, tsaka sa patents. Unahin natin yung patents. Okay, so before we go to patents, I will just show you some patented inventions. Ayan. Kaya sabi ko interesting ang ano, interesting intellectual property. Ayan. So, I guess all of us know Michael Jackson. Okay? So, just a trivia. Did you know that yung signature move niya na parang naka-slant Yung parang may anti-gravity illusion, okay? Pinapatent yan ni Michael Jackson, ayan, sa US. So it was granted a patent, okay? For creating that anti-gravity illusion. Di ba? Pag sumasayaw siya nung ano, parang moonwalk, tapos biglang maglilin or mag-islant. Okay, so may patent actually yan. And ito, nakakatawang patent rin sa US. So this is a solution for those of you who are so used to your alarm. And hindi na effective yung alarm. Okay, so this patent involves a hanging frame over your head. Okay, so it's attached to a cord and it's automatically released kapag hindi ka gumising, when your alarm is already on. Okay, so sabi ng inventor, the frame is light but not too heavy. Okay, so kapag bumagsak yan sa mukha mo, ano lang daw, magigising ka pero hindi ka naman masasaktan. Okay, so yan, may nakakatawang patent. So this was granted, anong taon na ba to? But 19, I cannot see. Pero matagal na siyang patent. Okay, another patent here. This is naman the solution for those of you who hates making their bed every morning. Okay, so maybe one of your longest running New Year's resolutions is to be more organized, which includes organizing your bed every morning. So there is a patent that was granted in 1999. So this is called the automatic bed maker. So this is designed to free people up from the time-consuming daily task of making beds. Okay, so ito, kapag gising mo, maayos na yung bed agad. Okay, and ito rin. For those of you who loves their beer, okay, so meron ring patent for beerbrella. Okay, so this beerbrella, there is an umbrella, as you can see, that is attached to the beverage. So the purpose is to protect the beverage from the direct rays of the sun. Okay, so believe it or not, meron patent na binigay dyan. Okay, and this one, there is actually a patent granted to Apple. Okay, so ang patent name, it's listed simply as electronic device. Okay, so this is an ornamental design of an electronic device, and if you ask anyone, pag pinakita mo yung ganyang design, alam na nila agad, di ba, that is iPhone. Okay, so Apple has a patent for it, but it's simply for electronic device. Okay, so now let's go to basic patent principles. Okay, so the primary purpose of the patent system is not to reward the individual. Okay, it's not to reward the individual for his invention. Like what I said, this is for the advancement of arts and sciences. Okay, so since inventions benefit the public, so in order to encourage the investors to disclose their inventions or their useful knowledge, okay, kaya meron tayong patent system to encourage dissemination of information concerning these patents. Okay. So the patent law, it has a threefold purpose. First, to foster invention. Second, to promote disclosure of those inventions. And third is in order for these inventions to be available to the public domain. Okay? So some patent principles. First, it's territorial. Okay? So when you are protected by a patent, it's only valid in the country. Okay, where it was granted. So kung gusto mong maprotektahan yung invention mo sa Philippines, apply ka sa Philippines. Hindi yan, yung patent application mo sa Philippines na nagrant, hindi yan mag-extend sa ibang bansa, like for example sa Canada. Okay, it's territorial by nature. Okay, and second principle for patent, what we call first to file. Okay, it's possible that there are two inventors, okay, who invented the same invention, although they did it separately and they were able to invent the same thing, okay, the patent will be granted to the first one who filed. Okay, so kahit sabihin ng isang inventor, ako nauna maka-invent niyan eh, pero for patent purposes, ibibigay yung protection kung kanino or kung sino yung unang nag-file ng patent. Okay, third, okay, for the disclosure. So in order for the state to give you a protection for your invention, kailangan i-disclose mo yung invention mo in a sufficiently clear and complete manner. Kasi nga, as you can remember, the purpose of patent is to promote disclosure of these inventions para magamit ng public. Okay? So it follows the quid pro quo principle, meaning you give, okay, in order for me to give as well. Okay, so protection in exchange for disclosure. Okay, number four principle, patent grant is conditional, meaning you must comply first with the requisites of patentability before you are granted the right to patent. Okay, and number five, its rights are only limited. Okay, so some basic patent principles. Now, let's discuss, ano ba yung mga inventions na pwedeng maging subject ng patent? Okay, so Section 21 of your Intellectual Property Code states that any technical solution of a problem. Okay, so yung mga naka-highlight at saka naka-bold na words, yan yung mga ano, important part ng definition. Okay, so it's any technical solution of a problem in any field of human activity which is new, involves an inventive step, and is industrially applicable. Okay, so kapag pasok ka dito, pwede kang maging subject sa patent. Okay, so it may be related to a product, like for example, a medicine or food, or it may also involve a process, like a method of manufacturing, a microbiological process, or an improvement of any of the foregoing. Okay, so hindi lang naman produkto, pwede rin process or improvement of the process or the way of producing a product. Okay, so more on criteria for patentability. I-discuss natin to isa-isa na mga naka-bold na words dito sa definition ng patentable invention. Okay, so you can see here the criteria for patentability. Okay, nakita nyo dito, di ba? Dapat new, dapat bago. Okay, in other words, it must be novel. Okay, when we say novelty, the invention shall not be considered new if it form parts of a prior art. Ano ibig sabihin ng prior art? When you say prior art, okay, I will not read the definition that you will see on your screen. I will... Prior art, lahat ng available na sa public bago ka nag-file. Okay? So, ang sinasabi ng patent, dapat pag magpa-file ka ng patent for your invention, dapat hindi pa yan available sa public. Dapat bago yan. Okay? Dapat meron kaming benefit na makukuha dyan kasi bago. Okay? So, if it already forms part of the prior art, kasi available niya na yan anywhere in the world, alam na yan ng public, di ba? Hindi ka na pwedeng maging, hindi ka na pwedeng granta ng patent. Like for example, ngayong 2021, di ba? May mag-apply ng patent for a light bulb, di ba? Hindi na yan mag-grant kasi sobrang tagal na siyang available to the public. Okay, so when we say prior art, it should not be available to the public by means of written description, by use, by oral description, or in any other way. Okay, so first criteria, novelty. Okay, so dapat hindi siya part ng prior art. Dapat bago. Okay, why is there a need for novelty? Okay, so I will go back again to the purpose or the ultimate goal of a patent system. Diba? The goal of a patent system is to bring new designs and technologies into the public disclosure. Okay? So if it's already available to the public, there's no more need for protection, di ba? So in order to encourage inventions, so that is why the law requires, dapat hindi siya part ng prior art. Okay? Second criteria, it must involve an inventive step. Okay? Meaning, it should not be obvious to a person skilled in the art. Okay, at the time of the filing date or priority date of the application claiming the invention. Okay, sa madaling sabi, dapat yung invention mo, it's something that really involves an inventive step. Okay, kailangan talaga mapakita mo how you were able to solve a technical solution. Kasi kung obvious yan, di ba, na parang, nag-apply ka ng patent, for a light bulb, ang ginawa mo lang is pinalitan mo, for example, yung color, ganyan. So it's already obvious to a person skilled in the art. It doesn't really bring an added value. Okay? So in order for a patent to be granted, it must involve an inventive step. Okay? Dapat merong binibring na solution to any problem in any field of activity. Okay? And third criteria, it must be industrially applicable. Okay, meaning the invention should be able to be used in any industry. Okay, in other words, it must have a purpose, a practical purpose. Okay, so those are your criteria for patentability. So when you are presented with a problem, is this invention patentable? You always go back to these three. Okay, novelty, inventive, step, industrially applicable. Okay, so tingnan mo lang lagi, bago ba ito? Ba itong inventive step? Meaning, hindi ba to obvious sa person skilled in the art na talagang meron siyang pinresent na technical solution sa isang problem in any field of human activity? And then lastly, meron ba itong practical purpose? Okay, so if an invention satisfies all the three requisites, then that's the time that patent can be granted. Okay? All right. Okay, so more on novelty. Okay, I skip this part. All right. Our general rule, when a work has already been disclosed to the public, it's not new anymore, diba? It shall be non-patentable. But there is an exception. Okay, what is the exception? This is the doctrine of non-prejudicial disclosure. What does it state? When you say doctrine of non-prejudicial disclosure, this is the period or the 12-month period before the filing date. Okay, for example, nag-file ka today. So today is August 23. 12 months before the filing date, okay, any disclosure that was made by the inventor or by the patent office or a disclosure by a third party without the knowledge of the inventor, that will not prejudice the patent application. Okay, you can still consider the invention as novel. Okay, as long as it falls within the 12-month period. Okay, so yun yung doctrine of non-prejudicial disclosure. The presumption is maybe because the disclosure was made to test the invention. Maybe because the disclosure was in order for the patent office to verify the information contained in the application. Okay, so if the disclosure was made 12 months prior to the filing date, then that is okay. Okay, that will not affect the novelty of the invention. Okay, so when you say it involves an inventive step, again, there is a test of non-obviousness. So dapat, okay, a person skilled in the art must not be able to draw inferences. And he must be able to see a technical solution that was done in order to create that patent or that invention. Okay, so those are the patentable inventions. Ano naman yung non-patentable inventions? Okay, so you have the plant varieties or animal breeds. Okay, so hindi yan patentable yung mga aesthetic creations. Okay, discoveries, scientific theories, and mathematical methods. So kung buhay ngayon si Einstein, hindi niya pwedeng ipa-patent yung formula niya. Okay, yung famous yung formula, hindi niya pwedeng ipa-patent because that is a mathematical method. Hindi mo rin pwedeng ipa-patent yung schemes, rules, and methods of performing mental acts, okay, or playing games, or even doing business. Okay, and even programs for computers that is non-patentable. And number five, anything which is contrary to public order or morality. Okay, so for example, you were able to invent a machine that is capable of producing fake money or fake coins or fake bills. You cannot apply for a patent for that because that is contrary to law. Diba? That is contrary to our public order. Okay. You cannot also apply for a patent for any method for treatment of the human or animal body. So, for example, meron nang naka-discover kung paano i-treat ang COVID. Hindi niya yun pwede ipapatent. Kasi imagine, especially in surgical procedures, andun ka na sa surgical table, tapos may gusto i-perform yung surgeon mo sa yun na method. Okay, imagine kung subject sa patent ang isang surgical method. Diba? Kailangan niya pang humingi ng permission doon sa patent holder bago i-perform sa'yo yung procedure. Diba? So for practicality and also for humanity purposes, you cannot apply for a patent for any method for treatment of the human or animal body. Okay, in case of drugs and medicines, if it's only a new form or property of a medicine that is already known, then it of a patent. We ask the question, is the COVID-19 vaccine patentable? Okay, ano bang naririnig nyo sa balita, di ba? This is a contentious issue and this is a hot topic for debate. Kung dapat ba i-subject pa sa patent yung COVID-19? Well, the answer to that is actually yes. COVID-19 vaccine is patentable since it's not a method for treating an illness. It's not a surgical method, diba? It's actually not a medicine. So it satisfies all the requisites for going debate. And some are actually saying that it is borderline inhumane for these drug companies to apply for a patent for COVID-19 vaccine because they are preventing other people from producing this vaccine, especially those that are coming from third world countries like us, di ba? So the idea is, if there is no longer a patent for the COVID-19 vaccine, then there can be mass production of the vaccine. Then mas madidistribute siya, di ba? I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that the anti-polio vaccine was not patented by its inventor. So when it was invented, it was allowed for use by the public. Okay, so hopefully, di ba, the manufacturers can also consider forgoing their patent application. Medyo ano kasi, there are two interests. Of course, yung material consideration because it's money, di ba? For their commercial undertaking, the demand is really high, pero yung supply sobrang konti. So naturally, all these manufacturers would want to protect their inventions, di ba? So magpapatent sila para they can also charge higher for their vaccines. But considering the suffering of the people from this pandemic, it's better to forgo the patent, di ba? But anyway, if you are presented with this basic question, patentable ba ang COVID-19 vaccine? The answer is yes. Okay. Ownership of patents. Kanino ba mapupunta yung patents? Well, of course, sa inventor. But aside from the inventor, pwede siya actually mapamana. Okay. So any invention that you may have and it's subject of a patent, it can be transferred to your heirs. You can even assign that. Okay. Now, what if there are two or more people who invented? Okay, so they shall own the invention jointly. Hati sila. Okay. Question, can patent rights be assigned or transferred? The answer is yes. Okay, you can assign a patent right. Okay, however, the requirement is it must be in writing and must be duly notarized. Okay, so for example, isa kang inventor, medyo gipit ka sa pera. You can assign your patent rights in exchange for a monetary consideration. Okay. More on first to file rule, na-discuss na natin doon sa basic principle, sabi natin, di ba? If two or more persons invented an invention separately and independently, okay, hindi naman sila magkakilala, but it so happened that they invented the same invention. Okay? Although, sabihin natin at the same time, at the exact same time, okay? The patent will still go to the person who filed an application for such invention first. Okay, so when I was in law school and our professor was talking about this first to file rule, when you go to the intellectual property office, there are instances now when the gap or the difference between the filing date or the filing time of certain inventions is only seconds. So ganun ka crucial yung first to file rule. So kung meron kang invention and you believe it's capable of being subjected to a patent, then apply ka agad kasi mahirap nang maunahan. Okay, so even though pwede, kaya mong i-prove na ikaw yung nauna as to invention, the rule is kung sino unang mag-file, okay, sa kanya yung patent. Okay, so first to file rule, whoever has the earliest filing date. Okay, how about inventions created pursuant to a commission? Like for example, you are a scientist. And then there is this company who went to you and then they presented a problem, they wanted a solution, okay? And you were able to create an invention that solved the technical solution, okay? Or that solved that problem, you provided a technical solution. What will happen to the patent and what will happen to your invention? Kanino yun mapupunta? Okay, so if an invention was created pursuant to a commission, okay, the person who commissions the work shall own the patent. Okay, so kung ikaw, hinire ka, for example, ng isang private company to create an invention and you were able to do so, the patent to that invention will belong to that private company. Okay, kasi sila yung nag-commission sa'yo. Unless, of course, you provided in the contract na sa'yo pa rin yung patent. Okay, if it's pursuant to unemployment. Okay, so for example, you are employed by Toyota Cars Philippines and you were able to invent a machine or an apparatus that enables Toyota cars to run on cooking oil, for example. So nakagawa ka ng ganong invention. Kanino mapupunta yung patent? Okay, so if you are an employee, we must know, is the invention part of your regular duties or not? If the inventive activity, okay, yung process mo ng paggawa ng invention, it's part of your regular duties, then it will belong to the employer. Okay, so if it's regular to you, like yun talaga yung job description mo, na gumawa ka ng inventions, hanapin mo kung ano yung pwedeng i-improve sa mga sasakyan ni Toyota, for example. If it's your regularly assigned duties, the inventive activity, the invention and the patent will belong to the employer. Okay? On the other hand, if the inventive activity is not part of your regular duties, okay, so nagkataon lang, mahilig ka lang talaga magbuting-ting. Okay, like for example, isa kang mekaniko. Okay, mekaniko, tapos hindi naman part ng duties mo sa Toyota na mag-invent ng mga aparatos or devices in order to improve cars. Okay, tag-ayos ka lang ng sasakyan, kaya lang magaling ka nga magbuting-ting. Okay, so for example, nakakreate ka ng invention and it's patentable. Kanino mapupunta? Okay, so since hindi part ng regular duties mo, yung invention mo, that will belong to you. Okay, even though you use the time, the materials, and the facilities of the employer, the patent will still belong to the employee. Okay, so pursuant to unemployment, I will summarize it. If it's part of your regularly assigned duties, patent will belong to the employer. If the inventive activity is not part of your regular duties, it will belong to the employee. Okay? So yun ang rule natin when it comes to inventions. Created pursuant to a commission and pursuant to employment. Okay? Alright. Now, how do you register a patent? Okay, so I will just show on my screen the procedure. Okay, just an outline of the procedure for filing for patent. So of course, you need to file the application. Okay, and then there will be an examination. Okay, you need to publish that application. There will be a substantive examination by the Intellectual Property Office. And then if it's sufficient and they found everything in order, they will grant it to you. Upon grant, if publish or it's a newspaper, and that's the time that you will be issued a certificate that the patent is already issued. Okay, so as to the application, there is just a requisite that it should contain the following. So, dapat andyan yung description ng invention. Okay, dapat andyan yung drawings. Andyan yung claims and any abstract. So, complete disclosure of your invention. Okay, para malaman rin ng Intellectual Property Office kung pwede talaga siyang masubject sa patent. Hopefully, you can still hear me because it's raining hard here. So, let me know kung hindi ako audible, ha? Okay. So in your disclosure sa patent application, kailangan ilagay mo dyan ano ba yung gusto mong i-claim. Okay, ano ba yung gusto mong i-claim na protection? Okay, ito yung invention mo, kailangan nilagay mo yung drawing, ilagay mo paano ba siya gamitin. Kaya yung mga pinakita ko sa inyong patent ay mga drawing, di ba? Kasi required silang i-disclose sufficiently. Okay? Salamat. Thank you so much. I'm already at the top of my voice. Okay? All right. Now, if you are already issued a patent, can it be canceled? The answer is yes. Okay, what are the grounds? Okay, and who may file? As to who may file, any interested party may petition to cancel your patent. On what grounds? Okay, first ground is if the invention is not new or patentable. Okay?
pwedeng sabihin ng interested party, hindi naman yan bago eh. Meron ng ganito yan eh. May mga ginagamit ng ganyan. So, bakit na-patent yan? Okay. So, pwedeng ipa-cancel on that ground. Okay. Second ground is if there was insufficient disclosure. Baka hindi complete yung disclosure. Okay. So, if it is the, if the patent does not disclose the patent in a sufficiently clear and complete manner, then pwedeng ipa-cancel. Okay. Number three ground is if it's contrary to public order or morality. Okay. So, if it's found na itong patent pala, it's contrary to public order or morality, pwedeng ipa-cancel. Okay. And if there was an action for patent infringement, pwede rin mapa-cancel. Okay. And if the patent include matters outside the scope of the disclosure contained in the application. Okay, so for any of the following grounds, the patent may be canceled. Okay. Now what will happen? Like for example, meron kang invention. Okay. Tapos may ibang nakakita ng invention. O ginaya ngayon. Ginaya. Okay. So ginawa nila sila yung nag-apply sa patent. Okay. Pinalabas nila na sila yung inventor. Okay. So what will happen to you as the true and actual inventor? What are your remedies? Okay. So if you are the actual inventor and it happened that there was someone else who applied for a patent for your invention, you have the following remedies. Okay. So within 3 months after the decision has become final as to the grant of patent, you can apply for another application. Okay. Use that application as if it is your own. You can say na, this is my invention. I am the true and actual inventor. Okay. Or you can either file a new application. Okay. You just file a new application and you submit evidence na ikaw talaga yung true and actual inventor. You can also request from the intellectual property office na ipa-cancel yung patent. Okay? So, or pwede rin sabihin mo, you refuse the application because I am the true and actual inventor. Okay? When should you file it? Within 1 year from the date of the publication. Kasi as you saw in the outline of grant of patent, di ba, meron doon na publication. Okay? So pagka-publish na nag-grant yung patent, yung true and actual inventor, meron siyang isang taon para mag-file ng remedies. Okay? Pwedeng cancel niya, pwedeng mag-apply siya ng bago, and then sabihin niya na siya yung true and actual inventor. Okay? So like what I said, you can claim that you be substituted as the patentee. Sabihin mo, wag na i-cancel yung patent, palitan na lang yung pangalan. Ako kasi yung true and actual inventor. Okay? Or ipa-cancel mo, then file ka ng bago. Okay? And aside from that, you can also claim for damages kasi ikaw yung ano, ikaw yung true and actual inventor. Okay? When again, within 1 year. Okay? From the time of publication. Okay. Now, ano naman kung meron kang patent? So what are the rights that are given to you by the state in case you were able to obtain a patent? In case of product, for example, naka-invent ka ng isang product, granting yung vaccine, okay, naka-invent ka ng COVID-19 vaccine, ano yung rights mo as the patent owner? Okay, ito yung mnemonics nyo dyan. M-U-O-S-I, M-U-O-S-I. Okay, so you have the right to restrain, prohibit, and prevent the making, the using, the offering for sale, the selling, or importing. Okay, sa madaling sabi, may control ka kung paano ibibenta, paano gagamitin, di ba? Paano i-import yung product mo kung ikaw yung patent owner. Okay, how about for process? For process, you also have the right to restrain, to prohibit, and prevent any unauthorized person or entity from using your process in producing their products. Okay? So, basically, the same lang. If we just simplify it, if you are the patent owner, you have the control kung paano dapat gamitin yung product mo, kung paano pwedeng gamitin yung process mo. Okay? So, they cannot do so without your consent. Okay? And aside from that, you also have the right to assign your patent. Okay, to transfer it by succession and to conclude licensing contracts. Okay, so these rights will only be conferred to you after publication. Okay, very important yung publication. Okay, however, even though you are given a right or the rights as a patent owner, there are still limitations to that patent rights. What are these limitations? Okay? So, if you, as the patent owner, already put your product on the market, halimbawa, kinomercialize mo na yung invention mo. Okay? Binenta mo na sa mga drugstores, for example. Hindi mo na pwedeng i-prevent yung mga tao na gamitin yung patented product mo. Kasi yun ano mo na, nilagay mo na sa market. Okay? So, hindi mo na pwedeng sabihin na, uy, ako yung patent owner niyan, huwag mong gagamitin. Okay? So, if you already introduced or put your product on the market in the Philippines, anyone can already use your patented product. Okay? And for drugs and medicines, okay, if a patented medicine is introduced anywhere in the world, like for example, yung gamot sa COVID, bago may naka-invento, okay? Kahit sa India, for example, unang binenta yung medicine na yon, pwede na tayo mag-import sa Pilipinas. Hindi na natin kailangan humingi ng consent doon sa patent owner ng gamot na yon for drugs and medicines, okay? So for drugs and medicines, kapag na-introduce na anywhere in the world, yung patent doon sa drugs and medicines na yon, pwede na rin nating gamitin. Okay? Pwede na rin nating i-import. Okay? You cannot also prevent a person who is only using your patented product for a non-commercial use. Okay? Baka ano lang, private lang naman. Or even for experimental use. Baka ano lang, tinitingnan lang if there is something to improve, di ba? So, hindi mo pwedeng i-prevent. And for drugs and medicines, hindi mo rin pwedeng i-prevent yung examination of the drug, yung testing, yung paggamit, and even the sale. Okay? Other limitations, you also have the right of prior user. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin ito? So, if there are persons other than the applicant, who in good faith started using the invention in the Philippines or undertaken serious preparations to use the same before the filing date or priority date shall have the right to continue the use thereof. Okay, but this right shall only be transferred or assigned further with this enterprise or business. Ano ibig sabihin niya? Like for example, may dalawang inventor. Okay? Si inventor 1 nasa Luzon. Si inventor 2 nasa Visayas. Okay? Si inventor 1, gusto niya maka-invent ng isang device or apparatus na kayang, gusto niya maka-invent ng isang device na kayang mag-transport ng human organs within minutes only. Kasi ano yun eh, very crucial sa mga human organs na ma-preserve tsaka ma-transport agad. So gusto niya maka-develop ng flying device na gano'n, parang drone style. So, si inventor 1, dine-develop niya yun, dine-invent niya. Si inventor 2, nagkaroon rin ng similar idea, although independent tsaka separate kay inventor 1. So, si inventor 2, naisip niya rin ganon, pero gusto niyang dagdagan ng GPS. Okay, so, parang the same yung kanilang inventions, pero medyo ano lang, advanced lang yung kay inventor 2. So, si inventor 2, natapos niya agad. Okay, so, since natapos niya agad, nag-file siya ng patent. Na nag-grant yung patent. Okay. Even though nagrant yung patent ni patent ay ni inventor 2 sa kanya yung patent, hindi niya pwedeng i-prevent si inventor 1 from using his invention although it's similar. Okay, why? Because inventor 1 is in good faith, di ba? He did not know that there is already an invention similar to his and a patent is already granted. Okay? So si inventor 1, although wala na siyang karapatan sa patent, he cannot be prevented from using his invention. Okay, although it's similar to an invention that is already patented. Okay, so to give you more example, ayan. Okay, so this is based on 2011 bar exam. So si X, nag-invent siya ng device na kayang mag-charge ng cellphone through use of noise. Okay, so nag-apply siya ng patent and then nag-grant. Okay, as it turns out, a year before the grant, may isang inventor rin who invented a similar device which he used in his cellphone business in Manila. Okay, so sabi ni X, ay, invention ko yan ah. Dapat matigil yan. Okay, so ang question natin, pwede bang ipatigil ni X na gamitin ni Y yung invention na similar sa kanyang patented device? The answer is no. Reason, because he is a prior user in good faith. Okay? Other limitations on the patent rights is the use by the government. Okay? So since gobyerno ito, di ba? State is king. Okay? So the government, in exchange for the protection that they give, okay, they can exploit the invention even without agreement from the patent owner in order to examine, in order to test, and in order to introduce it to the public in case of national emergency or in case of public interest. Okay? So, sa patent rin, meron tayong tinatawag na doctrine of exhaustion. So, lahat tayo pagod na. Doctrine of exhaustion. Okay, so this is also known as the doctrine of first sale. Ang ibig sabihin lang nito, kapag ikaw, patent owner, and then binenta mo, kinomercialize mo na yung invention mo, okay? From the time that you sold or you introduced your product to the public or to the market, okay, all your rights to control the distribution and the sale of your invention is already exhausted, okay? Introduce mo na yung market, yung product mo sa market, anyone can already resell your invention. Okay? So, meron ka rang control doon sa first sale. Okay? Pero yung mga subsequent sale, wala na. Okay? Hindi mo na pwedeng i-prevent yung ibang tao to resell your invention. Kung may gustong mag-buy and sell, di ba? So, hindi mo na pwedeng i-prevent. Okay? So, the presumption is, you already received all the royalties and consideration during your first sale. Hindi mo naman pwedeng i-monopolize yung sale ng invention mo. Okay? So, upon your first sale, yun na yun, exhausted na lahat ng rights mo. Subsequent sale, hindi mo na pwedeng i-control. Sabihin mo, ay, huwag mo ibibenta dyan sa part na yan or gusto ko dito lang. Okay? So, as an inventor, you only have the control for the first sale. Okay? Patent infringement. So, simply stated, this is a violation of the rights of a patent without consent. Okay, so you either made use, you offered for sale, or you sold or imported a patented product without the consent from a patentee. Okay, so if there is a patent, you may either literally or by equivalence. Ano ibig sabihin niyan? When you say literally, okay, there is an infringement which falls directly within the scope of properly interpreted claims. Okay? Ibig sabihin, talagang parehong-pareho. Okay? May mga may konti lang na may konti lang na variation pero parehong-pareho yung product na in-infringe. Like for example, merong binigay na patent claim for a biodegradable composition that is composed by resin and soy protein. Okay? It's actually plastic. Okay? So, if there is a subsequent product na ginamit rin yung resin tsaka soy protein, eh, pwedeng in-alter lang konti. Halimbawa, yung resin dinagdagan ng ibang material. Kahit sabihin mo na may konting variation, when you compare the two, diba, it falls exactly at the same composition. So, in that case, there can be infringement or literal infringement. Okay? So, it falls within the scope of the properly interpreted claims. Parehong-pareho. Okay? When you say naman doctrine of equivalence, dito hindi parehong-pareho. Ang nangyari lang, maybe may binagong isang ingredient. There is a slight modification, but the end product performs substantially the same function and it performs in the same way to achieve substantially the same result. Okay? So, function, means, and result test. Okay, so sa doctrine of equivalence, kahit sabihin mo na, uy, binago ko naman yung isang ingredient, ha? Okay, titingnan, okay, yung device or yung alleged na infringement ng isang patented product. So, titingnan as a whole, does it incorporate the innovative concept? Pareho ba yung function? Pareho ba yung means, yung way? Pareho ba yung result? Okay, so if the answer is yes, then there can be infringement by equivalence. Okay? So doon sa example natin, di ba sabi natin, meron for example na patented product, ang composition ay resin, tsaka, sabi natin, resin tsaka soy protein. So, for example naman, pinalitan natin yung resin, ginawa natin resin tsaka cornstarch. Okay? Resin tsaka cornstarch yung composition nabigyan ng patent. Meron na namang inventor nag-apply ng patent, instead of cornstarch, ang ginawa niya potato starch. Okay. Hindi niya pwedeng sabihin na, uy, potato starch ako, siya cornstarch. Okay.
So even though there is a slight modification, when you view it all together, pareho lang, di ba? Pareho lang yung innovative concept. Pareho lang rin yung function nila. Okay? Although there is a slight modification, appropriate pa rin yung innovative concept. So pwede pa rin magkaroon ng infringement. Okay, so what are your remedies if you are the owner? Okay, you can file a civil action for damages. You can also file for a criminal action. Okay, if the infringement is repeated. Okay, so your prescriptive period there is 3 years. You can also file for an administrative case with the Intellectual Property Office if the damage you are claiming is not less than 200,000. And you can also order for the destruction of the infringing material. Okay? What are your defenses in case you are alleged to infringe a patent? So, pwedeng sabihin mo invalid naman yung patent na yan or may grounds ka for cancellation or hindi naman yan bago eh. Okay? Or there was no sufficient disclosure. Or there were, the patent is contrary to public order or morality or prescribed na yung pag-file na. Okay, so in other words, pareho lang. Pareho lang dun sa grounds for cancellation. Okay, so that is for patent. Okay, I'll just request for a 2-minute break. I will just charge my laptop mabilis lang. Okay, sige. Lakas pa rin ang ulan dito. Anyway, okay, so that's for patent. Okay, now let's go to trademark. Ayan, medyo interesting rin to. Okay. So bago natin i-discuss yung provisions ng trademark, ayan, pakitaan ko lang kayo ng mga nakakatawang trademark. Okay, so ito, sa ano to? Sa China ata ito eh. Hindi man lang itinago yung panggagaya kay Jollibee, pati yung logo parehong-pareho, di ba? So, ang tawag ay Joy Rule B. Okay. I'm not sure kung sa China ito or sa Taiwan. Meron rin ito. Yan. Si Mang Inasar. Maasar ka sa sarap. Okay. Meron rin ito. Star Buhoks Salon and Spa. Yan. So, mga nakakatawa logo. Okay. Napaka-ano. Napaka-create. Anyway. So, trademarks. What are trademarks? So trademarks, this means any visible sign that is capable of distinguishing the goods or services. Okay? So pwede palang goods, pwedeng services. Okay? And it shall also include a stamped or marked container of goods. Okay? So sa madaling sabi, there is a mark and this mark distinguishes a goods or a services from the others. Okay, so that's a trademark. Okay, so in order for a trademark to be registered, it must be visible and it must be capable of distinguishing one's goods and services from another. Okay, dapat nakikita, dapat capable of distinguishing. Okay, so it's distinction that makes a mark subject of a trademark. Okay, so when we say visible sign, pwedeng words, pwedeng letters, pwedeng numerals, pwedeng figures, shapes, colors, logos, as you can see on your screen, pwede rin three-dimensional object or a combination of the foregoing. Okay? Ang mga hindi visible, you have scents tsaka sounds.
Okay, so sa Pilipinas, hindi pa tinatanggap yung soundmark. Sa ibang bansa, allowed na yan. Okay? So, siguro kung magkakaroon tayo no, or allow na ng Pilipinas yung trademark for sounds, isa siguro yung ano, selecta ba yun? Di ba? Yung pag umiikot, umiikot sa mga barabarangay, di ba? Pag narinig mo yung tunog na yun, alam mo na selecta yung umiikot eh. Or even scents, kung i-allow na sa Pilipinas, di ba? May mga scents na, ay, alam, or parang it reminds us of a product. Okay? So, sa Pilipinas, hindi pa yan allowed. So, there can be no trademark for sounds. There can also be no trademark for scents. Visible lang. Dapat visible. Okay? For trademarks, we have what we call distinctiveness. Okay? So, just an idea of the order or the level of trademarks. Okay? So, there are trademarks that are fanciful. When we say fanciful, ito yung mga gawa-gawa lang na words. Like Kodak. Polaroid. Yeah. There are also arbitrary trademarks. So these arbitrary trademarks, these are common words that are applied to a product that is totally unrelated. Like for example, yung Apple, di ba? Hindi naman siya related sa computer products, pero ginamit yung Apple. Okay, you also have suggestive trademarks. So it defines a characteristic of the product or service. Okay, descriptive, it's a description of the product, and you also have generic trademarks. Okay, so yung fanciful product, fanciful products, yung fanciful trademarks, ito yung strongest. Okay, so marked by distinctiveness, ito yung strongest. So more likely than not, if this is applied for a trademark, magagrant ito. Kasi gawa-gawa lang na words eh. So as you go below the ladder, okay, yan yung mga hindi na, no, or medyo mababa na yung distinctiveness. So baka hindi na mag-run. Okay? So ano ba yung pwedeng ma-register? Like what we said, pwedeng word, pwedeng name, pwedeng symbol, or any combination. Okay? There is a distinction between trademark and trade name. Baka nakita kayo trademark. May nakita rin kayong trade name. Okay. When we say trademark, this identifies or distinguishes the goods or services. Okay, so this is for the goods or services. For trade name naman, this distinguishes the business or enterprise. Okay, so for example, yung Nestle. Nestle is the trade name of a business. Okay, Milo, for example, or Bear Brand, there is a trademark for that product or for that goods. Okay, so for trademark, registration is required. So bago mo ma-appropriate yung mark na yan para ma-prevent mo yung ibang tao na gamitin yan, okay, kailangan mo munang iparegister. On the other hand, for trade name, that is not necessary. Okay? There are also collective marks. So this mark naman, this is used to associate a mark to a certain group or organization. So perfect example yan, itong halal. Okay, so when you see a halal certificate or a product, then you are assured na ano siya, that can be safely consumed by our Muslim brothers and sisters. Okay? So, paano kung business owner ka? Like for example, si Reyo, gusto niya itong ipa-trademark, itong R na may nakapalibot na yellow na ano, na parang orbit. Okay? Gusto niyang i-prevent lahat ng review center na gamitin yung ganyang logo. Or kahit lahat ng mga related na services, mga review school, mga nag-o-offer ng professional services. Sabi ni Reyo, gusto ko itong trademark na to, itong R na may bilog. Gusto ko, ano, ako lang may gamit. Okay, hindi pwedeng gayahe. Okay, hindi pwedeng, for example, may review center, gagawin ibang letter lang, tapos may bilog rin na ganyan. So kung gusto ni Reyo na ipasubject sa trademark ito, yan na logo niya. And even yung font, yung pagka-present mismo ng Real Excellence Online, kailangan niyang iparegister yung mark na yun. Okay? Because when a mark is registered, that's the time that you are given trademark rights. Okay? So kung hindi mo yan iparegister sa Intellectual Property Office, wala kang karapatan to prevent others na gamitin yung mark mo or to use a mark that is similar or identical to your mark. Okay? So if you want to protect your trademark, your logo, or anything that distinguishes your business or your goods, then you should file for registration. Okay? Because upon registration, then that's the time that you acquired ownership of that mark. Okay? So, it's registration that confers trademark rights. Okay? So, although upon registration, Rayo does not need to prove na ginamit niya yung logo na to, ganyan. But, it's still necessary that Rayo will be able to prove that he owns the mark, hindi niya ginaya, di ba? Hindi niya kinuha sa ibang business. So upon registration, then that can already constitute as a sufficient proof that he owns that mark. Okay? So exclusive na 'yan, hindi na pwedeng gayahin ng ibang related na services. Okay? So like what I said, prior use is no longer a requirement. Okay? However, after application, you should actually use that trademark. Okay? There is actually a requirement that within 3 years from the filing of the application, magpa-file ka sa Intellectual Property Office ng DAU or Declaration of Actual Use. Okay? So dito, papakita mo na nagamit mo nga yung trademark. Okay? Kasi pag hindi mo yan ginamit, tatanggalin sa'yo yung trademark na yan. Okay? So dapat, after 3 years, okay, mag-file ka ng declaration of actual use and i-prove mo sa Intellectual Property Office na ginagamit mo yung trademark na yun. So if you filed for a trademark registration, how long is the duration of the registration? The answer is 10 years. Okay? 10 years and then you can renew it indefinitely for 10 years each. Okay? So 10 years renewable. Okay? I don't know if I was able to mention sa patent. Sa patent, 20 years lang. Okay? Sa patent, 20 years lang ang protection. Non-renewable. Sa trademark, 10 years, subject to indefinite renewals. Okay? So, 10 years and then from filing of registration, magpa-file ka ng declaration of actual use. And aside from that, every 5th year anniversary, okay, within 1 year from your 5th year anniversary, magpa-file ka pa rin ng declaration of actual use. Okay, so medyo strict. Kailangan mo talagang ma-prove sa Intellectual Property Office that you are using this trademark exclusively. Okay? So what are non-registrable marks? Pag pumunta ka ba sa trademark office, agad-agad mas mag-grant yung trademark application mo. Okay? The following are not registrable mark. So first, those that are immoral, those that are deceptive, those that are scandalous. Okay? So hindi mo naman pwedeng ipa-register the trademark, tapos immoral yung word, or medyo shocking to the conscience yung itsura ng yung trademark, so hindi yan itagra. Second is, if there are matters or there is an indication in your logo, in your trademark, which may falsely suggest a connection with persons or any business. So kung babalikan nyo yung pinakita ko sa inyong example kanina, yung Star Buhox, di ba? So obviously, the logo of that salon was inspired from the logo of Starbucks. Kasi kahit pangalan, di ba, katunog. So if that salon applies for a trademark with the Intellectual Property Office, it will not be granted. Why? Although hindi similar yung nature ng business ng Star Buhox tsaka Starbucks, it may falsely suggest a connection because of the similarity. Okay? Of the similarity of the name, di ba? When you pronounce it, there is an oral similarity and pati yung itsura, almost the same. So it may falsely suggest na related sa Starbucks. And of course, it might confuse consumers of Starbucks na ay nag-extend na pala sa salon ng Starbucks. Okay, so hindi yan pwedeng maparegister. Okay, hindi mo pa rin pwedeng iparegister yung mga contrary to public order or morality na marks. Okay? In addition to that, hindi mo rin pwedeng iparegister yung marks that is similar to a flag or coat of arms of nations and the names, portraits, or signatures of living persons. Okay? Exception with consent. Okay? So, halimbawa, meron kang pirma ni Sir Rex. Gusto mong gawing trademark sa negosyo mo. Okay? Hindi mo pwedeng iparegister sa trademark unless may consent ka. Okay, hindi mo rin pwedeng gamitin as a trademark yung pangalan, portrait or signature of a deceased president. Okay, like for example, the late Ninoy Aquino. Okay, hindi mo pwedeng gamitin yung kanyang pangalan or kanyang portrait. Okay, exception with written consent of his or her living widow. So since hindi applicable kay Ninoy Aquino to, then the next of kin, mga sisters. So kung allow, then pwede na. Okay, and ito, hindi mo rin pwedeng ipa-register yung marks that is identical with a registered trademark belonging to a different proprietor or a mark with an earlier filing or priority date in respect of same goods or services or closely related goods or services, or if it nearly resembles such a mark to be likely to deceive or cause confusion. Okay, so isa rin itong ground para ma-deny yung application ng trademark ni Starbucks. Okay, so another example, in case na merong pupunta sa trademark office ng intellectual property office, for example, nagbebenta ng sapatos. Okay, nagbebenta ng sapatos, for example. Okay, and then ang gusto niyang ipangalan is Adidas. Okay, so instead na Adidas, ang nilagay niya is Adidas. Okay, nagbebenta rin siya ng sapatos, it's the same goods. Okay, and the name of his or the trademark that he wants to apply for, it nearly resembles, okay, the trademark of Adidas. Okay, so it will likely confuse the consuming public. Baka mamaya ang gusto nilang bilhin Adidas, kaya lang nakuha nila Adidas. Okay, so hindi yan i-grant ng Intellectual Property Office. Okay, for trademarks, applicable rin yung first to file rule. Okay, so kung sino yung mauna, then siya yung bibigyan ng right to that trademark. Okay. And just a trivia. 'Di ba pag may nakikita kayong ganyan sa mga kinokonsume yung products, ayan, ganyan. TM. Yan ibig sabihin niyan, the product is already subject of a trademark. Okay? So kapag may nakita kayong product tapos may TM na bilog na nakapalibot, ibig sabihin may trademark 'yan. Okay? Paano naman yung may nakalagay na ganyan? R. Pag nakalagay pa lang ganyan, hindi pa ini-issue yung trademark, it's still in the process, okay, of issuance. Pwedeng naka-apply na pero hindi pa nagagrant yung trademark. Okay, so next time, diba, tingnan nyo, ano na kaya ito? Subject na kaya ng trademark. Okay? Sige. More on non-registrable marks, hindi rin pwede yung misleading marks, yung mga generic terms. Okay, hindi mo pwedeng magpa-register ka ng trademark for a bed, tapos ang pangalan mo bed. Okay, so it's so generic. It's not distinctive, so hindi pwede. Okay, hindi rin pwede yung color alone. Okay, hindi mo pwedeng ipa-trademark yung word na red, for example. Or even shapes, hindi mo pwedeng ipa-trademark. Okay? Even descriptive terms, hindi rin pwede. Okay? Another non-registrable marks are those marks that are identical with internationally well-known marks. Okay, so what are internationally well-known marks? So these are marks that are famous or that are of common knowledge to the consuming public. Okay, or to the relevant sector of the consuming public. Like for example, ang Louis Vuitton. Okay, although hindi siya mag-apply ng trademark sa Pilipinas, walang business sa Pilipinas na pwedeng mag-apply for trademark for Louis Vuitton. Why? Because Louis Vuitton is an internationally well-known mark. Okay? So kahit hindi mag-apply ng trademark dito sa Pilipinas si Louis Vuitton, i-deny yan ng Intellectual Property Office because that will be confusing to consumers and that will also be violative of the rights of Louis Vuitton. Okay? So for internationally well-known mark, kahit hindi sila registered dito, okay, and kahit hindi similar yung goods or services na gusto nung iparegister sa Pilipinas, that will still be denied. Okay? Ano naman ang rights mo sa trademark owner? For example, yan, gamitin ulit natin si Rayo. Okay, so itong logo ni Rayo, pati yung presentation mismo ng kanyang business. Okay, In-apply niya sa intellectual property office na bigyan ng trademark. Ano yung rights niya sa trademark owner? So first, let's start with the obvious. He has the exclusive use of the mark. Okay? So hindi pwedeng gayahin, walang pwedeng na gumawa ng logo or ng kahit anong mark na identical or similar sa logo ni Rio. Okay? So kung may merong gumawa noon, pwede niyang i-prevent. Okay? But take note, the trademark registration is only territorial. Okay? So kung nag-apply ka dito sa Pilipinas, may trademark ka dito, hindi yan mag-extend sa US unless you are a well-known mark. Okay? So, dun sa Louis Vuitton, di ba? Kahit hindi siya nag-apply ng registration sa Pilipinas since kilala siya internationally, no need na to apply for registration here. Okay? So, any trademark that is confusingly similar or identical to the trademark of Louis Vuitton, i-deny yan. Okay? So, if you violated the rights of a trademark owner, so, for example, yung kalaban ni Rayo na ano, na review center, gumawa rin ng sarili nilang logo. Tapos, pag tinignan mo, kinumpare mo sa logo ni Rayo, pareho. Okay? So, that's the time that there can be a trademark infringement. Okay, so trademark infringement, this is the use without consent of the trademark owner of any reproduction, counterfeit, copy, or colorable imitation of any registered mark or trade name. Okay, so gamitin natin yung example ni Jollibee, tapos ni Joey Rulby. Okay, so in that case, magkakaroon ng trademark infringement. Okay, so very, ano, very aggressive dito yung mga businesses. They are so protective of their trademark kasi of course it means money. Okay? So ayan, yung Jollibee, even McDo, okay, meron niya na kaso na yung Big Mac, okay, yung Big Mac nila na product, okay, merong gumaya, instead na Big Mac, ginawa Big Mac. Ganyan. So syempre, kinasuwa nila at nakarating sa Supreme Court, panalo naman si McDo. Okay? So, hindi lang yan combination of names, hindi lang yan combination of symbols. That is their business. So, if you have a trademark and that is registered, diba, you will do everything in your power to protect your image, diba, to protect that mark because that is your business. So, it involves a lot of money kung kakasuhan ka for trademark infringement. So, be very careful rin in case magbi-business kayo, diba. I-make sure nyo na hindi ano, that will not result in trademark infringement. Hindi siya magmumukhang gaya ng isang registered trademark, di ba? Kasi if not, pwede kang makasuhan for trademark infringement. Okay? So as to elements, so first, dapat merong trademark that is already registered and you reproduced it, you counterfeited it, or you copied it, or colorable imitation. And walang consent, ginamit mo. And number five, there is likelihood of confusion. Okay? Lumilit ko lang. Pasensya na. Okay? So when we say likelihood of confusion, that is a relative concept. So it depends on the circumstances. So titingnan pa rin yung itsura ng trademark. Will it confuse an ordinary purchaser? Na kapag kinumpare mo, ay, malilito ka. Diba? So, in that case, titingnan. Okay, titingnan kung magkakaroon ba ng confusion. If you compare the trademark and the trademark that is alleged to be violative of the registered trademark. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin ng colorable imitation? So, when we say colorable imitation, hindi gayang-gaya. Hindi talaga counterfeit. When you say kasi counterfeit, talagang yung mga nakikita nyo sa Green Hills, yung nakikita nyo sa Green Hills, like, yung mga bags dyan, yung mga sapatos na Nike, yung mga Adidas, talagang gayang-gaya, yung tinatawag nilang Class A. Yun, counterfeiting nyo. Kapag colorable imitation, ginagaya lang yung itsura nung product and yung imitation ng product, it gives a resemblance na pareho. Okay? So, there is still a confusion kasi although magkaiba yung product, pero kapag kinumpare mo, makikita mo yung panggagaya. Okay? So, tibigyan ko na lang kayo ng example. So, ito yung counterfeiting. Okay? So dito parehong-pareho talaga. Okay? Walang binago, pati yung spelling ng Nike, pati yung logo ginaya. Pero fake. Fake na product. When you say colorable imitation, ayan, pinalitan yung Nike, ginawang hike. Okay? Tapos yung check, binago ng konti. Ayan. So this is still trademark infringement kasi an ordinary purchaser will still be confused. Baka hindi lang nagtitingin, di ba, hindi nagbabasa, nagulat siya, sabi niya isang Nike nga po na chinelas, pag uwi niya biglang hype. Okay? So, even though there is a slight variation or slight modification in the product, that is still considered as trademark infringement kasi may colorable imitation. Okay? So, in confusion, there can be confusion of goods, there can also be confusion of business. Okay, when you say confusion of goods, this refers to the goods themselves. Okay, when you say confusion of business, this refers to the source or origin of such goods. Okay, so for example, ginamit ang name na Colgate, pero sa sabon. Okay, so kahit sabihin mo na, ay hindi naman ano ha, hindi naman sa toothpaste ginamit yung Colgate. Okay. There can still be trademark infringement because it confuses the public. Baka isipin, ay, may sabon na pala yung Colgate. Diba? So, there will be confusion of business. So, even though hindi similar yung products but related, okay, that can still be considered as trademark infringement because there will be confusion. Okay? In order to test the confusion, we have two kinds of tests. Okay, so we have dominancy test. So dominancy test focuses on the prevalent features of the competing marks. Okay, titingnan, i-compare yung products. Okay, pag kinumpare mo yung kanilang logo, okay, yung prevalent features niya, is it confusing? Okay, so example natin dyan, itong si Papa Ketcharap tsaka si Papa Boy Lechon Sauce. Okay. So umabot yan sa Supreme Court. Pinag-awayan, sino? Si Papa. Okay, pinag-awayan yung word na Papa. Okay. Sabi ni UFC, Poy Papa Boy Lechon Sauce, huwag mong gagamitin yung Papa kasi that is already our mark. Okay, registered yan. Okay, hindi mo pwedeng gamitin yung word na Papa. Okay. Sabi naman ni Papa Boy Lechon Sauce, may alteration naman ah. Although ginamit ko yung word na Papa, hindi ko naman, dinagdagan ko naman ang words na boy tsaka lechon sauce. Okay, so umabot sa Supreme Court ang pinagtalunan, yung word ba na papa, can that be exclusively appropriated by UFC for their Papa Ketcharap? Okay, so sabi ni Supreme Court, yes. Yung papa mapupunta lang kay UFC. Why? Kasi when you read these two marks, ang dominant feature niya, yung word na papa. Okay? So since pareho silang may papa, it's already confusing. Okay? And pareho pang nasa simula, di ba? It's the first word of these marks. So sabi ni Supreme Court, focusing on the prevalent features of the competing marks, Papa Boy Lechon Sauce, bawal mong gamitin yung papa. Okay? As we know it, yung Papa Ketcharap kay UFC lang. Okay? Ito rin, isang case. Yung Philips, yung light bulb, meron din siyang nakaaway na Phil Lights. So, sabi ni Supreme Court, pareho kayo may word na Philly. Okay? So, dominant rin yung words na yan. So, medyo confusing rin. Okay? Another test is yung totality test. So, sa dominancy test, ang focus lang is yung prevalent features. Sa totality test, ang pinafocusan lang is yung overall impressions. So lahat, hindi lang yung dominant. So yung color, yung presentation, yung font, lahat. Pati yung tunog, okay? Iko-compare, okay? So totality test. So the totality test is used in this case. So if you would be so kind, pwede kayo mag-comment. Sa tingin nyo ba pareho itong company? Yung mga gumagamit siya ng baong. Itong Lee, tsaka stylistic MR Lee. Do you think these are the same products? Or do you think they belong to the same company? Okay, kung may nakikinig pa sa akin. What do you think? When you look at these two trademarks, when you compare them, are you confused or do you think that they are you know, the same products. Pag pumunta kayo sa mall, pag tinignan nyo yung dalawang pantalon na ito, dalawang brand, ano yung naiisip nyo? Is that the same? Or pagkaiba? Ganyan? What do you think? Okay. Wala na ata nakikinig sa akin. Well, anyway. Okay. So, believe it or not, ayan, confusing. Okay. Same company may gawa. Confusing po. Okay. To be honest, that is also my answer. Okay? And everyone else. Okay? Different ba? Sa tingin nyo, different. The answer to that, kung hindi ko ito nabasang kasong to, hindi ko malalaban na magkaiba pala tong kumpanyang to. Okay? Magkaiba si Lee, magkaiba si Stylistic Mr. Lee. Okay? So, ang naunang gumamit ng word na Lee, ito, si Lee na maong pants. So, kinasuhan niya to si Stylistic Mr. Lee. Kasi sabi niya, tingnan mo naman, ginamit yung word na Lee. Okay? Parehong-pareho, oh. Okay? Parehong-pareho. Pati yung font, parehong-pareho. Okay. Sabi ni Supreme Court, hindi naman. Kasi ang maong pants, hindi naman yan mura. Okay? So, kung bubili ka ng pantalon, okay, yung isang buyer, okay, mas magiging ano siya, maingat siya sa pagpili ng pantalon. So sabi ni Supreme Court, dahil mahal ang pantalon, hindi naman confusing. Okay, yung iba ang hahanapin nila, li lang, yung word lang na li. Yung iba naman, hahanapin nila yung may stylistic Mr. Li. Okay? So sabi ni Supreme Court, considering the totality of the circumstances and considering na mahal ang pantalon, sabi ni Supreme Court, walang confusion. Okay? So, sa mga sumagot na confusing, nag-disagree si Supreme Court sa inyo. Okay? Sabi ni Supreme Court, anong confusion dyan? Eh, hindi naman mahalang pantalon. I-check nyo na lang kung liba yan o stylistic mister. Pero honestly, before I went to law school, akala ko talaga pareho yung dalawang nito. Okay? Well, anyway. Okay? Alright. In considering if there is confusion, we also use the item sonnets rule. So, titingnan yung oral effects of the words kung pag binasa mo ba, magkatunog. Like, for example, itong picogenol tsaka PCOgenol, yan, may infringement rin daw. Yung dermaline tsaka dermaline, may infringement. Pati ito, si nani tsaka si nan, may infringement because of the word nan. Okay, so nakakatuwa ang mga kaso for trademarks. Okay? Yung mga simpleng combination of words, pinag-aawayan. Ginagastos na ng bilyon. Okay? Alright. So for trademark, we also have what we call doctrine of secondary meaning. Okay? So the doctrine of secondary meaning simply states that although there is a word or a phrase that is originally incapable of appropriation, either because it's descriptive or it's geographical by nature, if it has been used for so long, okay, it can already acquire secondary meaning. Okay, like for example, yung sandal na antibay, hindi ko alam kung alam nyo yun, yung antibay na sandal, okay, yung word na antibay, di ba ano siya, descriptive, hindi naman talaga, originally hindi siya pwedeng masubject sa trademark kasi ano eh, description lang na matibay. Kaya nga lang, since ginagamit na siya for so long ng antibay, it already acquired secondary meaning. So since ang tagal na niyang ginagamit, yung word na ang tibay, although descriptive lang, pwede nang maging subject of trademark. Okay, so I will just present to you some case. So dito pinag-awayan yung De La Salle. Okay, so meron palang De La Salle Montessori International of Malolos Incorporated. Okay, so nagkasuhan, of course, si De La Salle, DLSU, tsaka si De La Salle Montessori. Okay, sabi ni De La Salle, hoy, bakit gumagamit ka ng De La Salle? Eh, amin yan. Sabi ni, sabi ni De La Salle Montessori International, hindi naman, kasi ang word na De La Salle, it comes from the word classroom. That's a French word for classroom. Okay, so hindi nyo yan pwede appropriate. Okay, sabi ni Supreme Court, no, because the word De La Salle has already been associated with De La Salle Brothers, okay? Kasi yung De La Salle, it came from the surname of De La Salle Brothers. Pero yung word na De La Salle, it also refers to the French classroom. Okay? So sabi ni Supreme Court, yung De La Salle kasi that is already arbitrary for De La Salle University, and if we allow you to use De La Salle, okay, there might be a confusion among the students and among the parents that you are connected with De La Salle University. Okay, so hindi inallow. Okay, so sayang, di ba? Kung taga Bulacan ka, tinanong ka, saan nag-aaral yung anak mo? Sa De La Salle. Tapos pag tinanong yung kompleto, De La Salle Montessori. Okay, so hindi yan. Hindi na inallow yung word na De La Salle. Okay. Pero yung ano, Lyceum, there's a case, yung Lyceum na word, okay, kung mapapansin nyo, ang dami sa Pilipinas na may Lyceum sa pangalan. Okay, yung Lyceum Manila, gusto sana nilang i-appropriate yung word na Lyceum. Kaya lang hindi pinayagan ni Supreme Court kasi yung Lyceum daw, that is a word for university. Okay, so since it's generic, hindi siya pwedeng ma-subject of a trademark. Okay. So another case that you might be interested in, so yung mga taga Ortigas dyan, so di ba meron doon na St. Francis Square, tapos sa Shangri-La, meron rin na St. Francis Shangri-La Place. So sa St. Francis Square, kinasuhan niya to si Shangri-La. Sabi niya, hoy, ba't gumagamit ka ng St. Francis? Eh yung St. Francis, amin na yan. Pag sinabing St. Francis, kami na agad yung naiisip. Sabi ni Supreme Court, anong sinasabi mo na sa inyo na yung St. Francis? Okay, yung St. Francis, that's a geographical place. Yung street na kahabaan yan, that's St. Francis Street. Okay? So sabi ng Supreme Court, hindi mo pwedeng appropriate yan because that's a name of a street. And hindi mo pa naman yan sobrang tagal na ginagamit that it already acquired secondary name. Okay? So related to trademark registration is unfair competition. Okay, magkaiba yung trademark infringement sa unfair competition. Sa unfair competition, it's the passing off or attempting to pass off a goods, okay, with the end and probable effect of deceiving the public. Okay? So dito, binibigyan niya yung goods niya ng general appearance para magmukhang goods nung kalaban. Okay? Kaya unfair competition. Okay? So to distinguish trademark infringement versus unfair competition, in trademark infringement, there is an unauthorized use of trademark. In unfair competition, there is a passing off of one's goods as those of another. For trademark infringement, hindi kailangan na may fraudulent intent, while for unfair competition, kailangan may fraudulent intent. Okay, for trademark infringement, prior registration of the trademark is a prerequisite, while for unfair competition, kahit walang registration, pwedeng mag-file ng unfair competition. Okay, so kung ikaw, meron kang trademark pero hindi mo naman pina-register, pwedeng ito yung remedy mo. So halimbawa si Rayo, merong nakalaban na review center, tapos yung logo niya almost the same, pwede niyang kasuhan for unfair competition. Okay? Kasi hindi pa naman siya nagpa-register for trademark. May example of unfair competition, ayan, di ba? Unang tingin mo, kala mo Dove, yun pala, Dave. Okay? So yan example ng unfair competition. Okay? Remedies and jurisdiction for trademark infringement. You can also file for civil action. You can also file for a criminal action. Okay. Last topic, copyright. Okay. Okay pa ba kayo? All right. Malapit na matapos. Okay. For copyright naman, copyright refers to the literary and artistic works. Okay. So, this, they are protected from moment of creation. Okay, so itong video lecture ko, di ba? As I am speaking, I am already protected by copyright. Hindi ko kailangan to iparegister. Okay, may copyright na agad to. Or itong material ko, like for example, may nag-screenshot, may nag-share sa ibang group. Okay, for example, may nag-screenshot, share yung material, ganyan. So, hindi ko na kailangan ipa-register para kasuhan ka ng copyright infringement. Because when it comes to copyright, they are protected from moment of creation. Okay, so kapag nagsulat ka ng novel, for example, nagsulat ka ng libro, yung libro, pina-photocopy mo, yung buo, ginawa mong book-alike, di ba? So, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na, uy, wala ka namang registration. So, for copyright, as distinguished from trademark and patent, copyright is protected from the moment of creation. Okay, so what are copyrightable works? So we have ayan, yung mga books, lectures like this one. You also have musical composition, computer programs. They're subject of copyright. You have photos, yan, works of art, yan, dramas, choreography, yan. Even derivative works like yung mga adaptations sa Netflix, yan. Yung mga scholarly works, yung mga dissertations, so that is subject of copyright. Mga non-copyrightable works, yan. Pleadings, yung mga pina-file sa court, hindi. Yung mga laws, okay, so kapag nag-download kayo ng copy ng batas, kahit ipag-photocopy nyo pa yan ng ilang beses, hindi yan copyright infringement because that is an official text of a law. News of the day, hindi rin. Okay, so kung balita lang naman, hindi yan copyrightable. Okay, idea or principle or even discovery, hindi rin pwede. TV programs, hindi allowed. Okay, pati yung format. Okay, so hindi pwedeng ipa-copyright, for example, yung format ng game ka na ba? Hindi yan subject of copyright. Systems of bookkeeping, so accountants, hindi yan subject of copyright. Okay. Question, are telephone directories copyrightable? Alam niyo yung ano, yung yellow pages, yung makapal na libro na ano, color yellow, kung saan makikita mo yung mga numbers. Okay. So are they copyrightable, yung telephone directories? The answer is no. Okay, why? Because directories are only a compilation of the numbers of a lot of people. Diba? There is no creativity there. Diba? Wala namang modicum of creativity. Unless, siguro, nilagyan mo ng ano, description or kung ano man na artistic, merong artistic value. Pero kung compilation lang naman siya, hindi siya copyrightable. Okay. So, what are the rights of copyright owners? Okay. So, as a copyright owner, you have economic right. Okay. So, for example, gumawa ka ng libro. So, you as the author, you have the right to prevent or authorize or carry out the reproduction of your work in case of compositions, in case of dramas, novels. You also have the right to carry out derivative works. Yung first distribution, ikaw rin yung may right to authorize. Yung public display, public performance, and other communications to the public, you have the right as a copyright owner. And technically, di ba? For example, isa kang TikTokerist or isa kang vlogger. Okay, nag-cover ka ng kanta ni Dua Lipa, for example. Since Dua Lipa owns the copyright to her songs, ideally, unless meron siyang agreement with her managers or with her talent company. Halimbawa, si Taylor Swift na lang, siya yung nag-compose ng mga kanta niya. Okay? So from the moment of creation, okay, meron siyang copyright to that composition. Technically, if you perform publicly one of her songs, halimbawa, nag-cover ka ng Cardigan, okay, in-upload mo sa YouTube. Since it's a public performance, technically you are infringing Taylor Swift's copyrights. Okay? Technically. Okay? But of course, hindi naman na yan inahabol lahat. Okay? And even public performance. Halimbawa, gagamitin mo yung Cardigan for a play, for a movie, for example. So kailangan mong bayaran si copyright owner kasi part yan ng kanyang economic rights. Okay. As to the duration of economic rights, general rule 50. Okay, 50 years. Okay. Kaya kung mapapansin nyo, lalo na si ano, sino ngayon? Si DJ Khaled. Okay. Ang ginagawa niya, pinapalabas niya na ano niya, co-producer niya yung anak niya. Bakit? Kasi ang protection ng copyright, that is 50 years, and lifetime of the author plus 50 years after your death. And it will start on January 1 following your death. Halimbawa, namatay ka ng September, yung 50 years magsisimula January 1 ng 2022. Okay? So, yung ibang mga producers like si DJ Khaled, matatalino. So, ang ginagawa nila, para mas matagal yung protection sa mga compositions nila, nire-register nila na yung anak nila, na co-producer, whatever. Okay? Para yung 50 years magka-count from the death of any of the remaining authors. Okay? So, yun ang protection ng copyright. Okay? aside from economic rights, you also have moral rights. So this is the right to be attributed. Now, ito ang ano, siyang author. Hindi mo yan pwedeng i-alter. Kailangan i-preserve yung integrity. Okay? Hindi mo rin pwedeng associate yung pangalan ng author sa isang creation na hindi naman sa kanya and vice versa. Okay? So how about the duration of moral rights? Perpetual. Okay? So kahit patay na si Shakespeare, kahit expired na yung 50 years niya, di ba? He still has the right to be attributed to his works. Hindi naman pwedeng palitan si Shakespeare na siya yung nag-compose ng mga ano niya, compositions. Okay? However, some of the moral rights like yung alteration and non-publication, that's coterminous with economic rights. Okay? That is why, halimbawa, yung Pride and Prejudice, okay? Since tapos na yung protection ng economic rights, okay? Yung moral right niya, hindi pwedeng i-alter yun. Expired na rin. Okay, kaya mapapansin nyo, meron ng mga modification. Meron ng Pride, Prejudice, and Zombies. Yan. So since, although it is based on Pride and Prejudice, pwede nang i-alter kasi expired na yung 50 years. Okay. Ano mangyayari? Halimbawa, tapos na yung 50 years. Okay, tapos na yung 50 years. Namatay na yung author, tapos na rin yung 50 years. Ano yung mangyayari doon sa copyrighted work? Okay, so from the time or from the expiration of the copyright, it will be transferred to the public domain. Okay, meaning anyone can do whatever with the work. Pwedeng i-alter, pwedeng i-adapt, okay? Pwedeng gawing drama, pwedeng Netflix, di ba? Merong Pride and Prejudice sa Netflix eh. So since tapos na yung ano, it will be transferred to public domain. Ang copyright kasi hindi siya extendable. Okay, so yan. Okay, as to ownership, of course, it will belong to the author in case two or more co-authors. Okay. For audiovisual work, you have producers. Okay. For anonymous work, it will belong to publishers. For commissioned work, okay. For example, ito. Halimbawa, I was hired by Rayo to perform a lecture or to make an handout for the refresher course. Kanina mapupunta yung work? Okay, the answer, this video lecture is owned by Rayo. But the copyright shall remain with the creator. Okay, so kung sino yung gumawa ng material, for example, then that will remain with the author unless there is a written stipulation to the contrary. Okay, so kung ikaw, for example, isa kang artist, may nakakita sa'yo sa Twitter, di ba usong-uso yan sa Twitter, yung nagpapa-commission, ba? Oo, nagpapa-commission ng artwork. The impact of CREATE law to today's commercial and business transactions. So meron kang po article. Kanino mapupunta yung copyright doon sa article mo? So similar with patent, we ask the question, yung copyrighted work mo ba, is it something that is assigned to you or is it part of your regular duties or not? If it is not part of your regular duties, even though you use the time, facilities, and materials of the employer, then it will belong to the employee. Okay? If it is part of your regularly assigned duties, it will belong to the employer unless there is an agreement to the contrary. Okay? Copy? Okay. So that's the rule for copyright. How about for letters? Oh, halimbawa, may nililigawan ka, nagsulat ka ng love letter. Okay, so old school ka, gumawa ka ng love letter. Kanino mapupunta yung copyright ng letter? Okay. So yung copyright ng letter, mapupunta pa rin sa writer. However, the letter itself will belong to the recipient. Okay? So for copyright infringement naman, so here, there is a valid copyright. Okay, and there was an exercise of any of the exclusive economic rights without consent. Ay, ganun naman lagi sa infringement, without consent. Okay, exception, fair use. I-discuss natin mamaya yung fair use. Okay,
So in other words, in order to constitute as a copyright infringement, it must be both unauthorized and unfair. Okay? Kasi pwede palang magkaroon ng copyright infringement na fair. Okay? Pero kapag both unauthorized at unfair, that is already copyright infringement. Okay? So ito, for example, yan. So this one, this is an original photo taken by a known photographer. This one, this is a sculpture. So is there a copyright infringement or not? Very obvious, di ba? Talagang gayang-gaya, di ba? So this is a form of derivative work. So hindi pwedeng i-appropriate yung idea ng photograph and transform it into sculpture. So dito mayroong copyright infringement. Another example of copyright infringement, yung mga bus na nagpi-play ng movies, di ba? Minsan yung mga latest pang movies sa bus, yung pinapakita. Yan. So that is actually copyright infringement. Now let's discuss fair use exception. Okay, so sabi natin, pwede mo palang gamitin yung copyrighted work as long as fair yung paggamit. So kailan mako-consider na fair? Okay? You can consider use of a copyrighted work without consent as fair use if it is used for criticism, for comment, for news reporting, for teaching, including limited number of copies for classroom use, for scholarship, for research, and similar purposes. Okay, so for example, you quote a book without permission of the author for a school paper. Okay, technically, it will not constitute as infringement. Okay, kasi for fair use, ginamit mo for classroom use, for scholarship. However, pwede kang, for failure to attribute the author, pwede kang ngayong sabihan na you committed plagiarism. Okay? Pero for copyright infringement, pwede mong defense, fair use. Kasi ano lang naman siya, for scholarship purposes, for research purposes. However, what if you photocopied an entire book? Ano ba yung libro ni Sir Rex? Pinaphotocopy mo yung sa kaklase mo, yung buong libro. Pinaphotocopy mo, pumunta ka sa recto, pinabukalat mo. Pwede po bang sabihin na fair use? Kasi for classroom use naman po. Okay. The answer to that, no. Okay. That cannot anymore be considered as a fair use because you are already copying the substantial portion of the book. Okay. Lahat na ng libro, buong libro na pinaphotocopy mo. Okay. So when you copied the entire book, okay, or the substantial portion of it, that can already constitute as copyright infringement. Okay? So in determining fair use, kailangan tingnan yung purpose, yung character ng use, yung nature ng copyrighted work, gaano ba kadami yung kinopya, ano ba yung effect on the potential market for value of the copyrighted work. Okay? So next time na magpapa-photocopy ng material, isipin. Okay? Although there is a fair use exception, exception lang yan, hindi yan yung general rule. Okay? So, yung pag-share nyo ng materials, mga video lecture, mga handouts sa mga groups or sa mga classmates na hindi naman authorized, okay? So, that can constitute as copyright infringement which may subject you to criminal and civil penalties. Okay? May pananakot ng konti. Okay? So, who are liable for infringement? Of course, whoever that committed infringement, even those who benefited, okay, from the infringement. So yung mga magkakaklase na nagpatak-patak para meron silang pang-book alike. Okay, so kahit hindi ikaw mismo yung nagpa-photocopy pero nag-benefit ka, pwede ka pa rin maging liable for infringement. Okay? Or even if you just induced another, or you materially contributed to the infringing conduct, there can also be infringement. Okay? Distinction between copyright infringement and plagiarism. So like what I said, so sa copyright infringement, we already defined. So this is unauthorized and unfair use of a copyrighted work. Sa plagiarism naman, this is the use of another's work without proper acknowledgement. Okay? Although you are allowed to quote a specific work, okay? Kapag wala kang attribution, wala kang acknowledgement, pwedeng plagiarism. So comparing the definition of the two, mas broad. Okay? Mas broad yung copyright infringement. Okay, so what are the remedies in case of copyright infringement? Okay.
So the following, so pwedeng mag-file ng injunction, okay, patigil, yung pag-infringe, pwede rin mag-claim ng damages, okay, pati yung legal costs, pati yung nawalang profits, pwede i-claim sa'yo. Pwede rin ipasira yung copies, okay, without any compensation. Pwede rin ipa-impound yung documents. Pwede rin mag-claim ng moral and exemplary damages and seizure of any evidence. Okay? So that's copyright infringement. Okay? So lastly, let us look at the distinctions between copyright, trademark, and patents. Okay? As to the basis, so just to remind you again, a patent, this is a technical solution of a problem in any field of human activity which is new and industrially applicable. Okay, for trademark, this is a visible sign and it's capable of distinguishing a good or service. For copyright, these are literary and artistic works. Term of protection for patent, 20 years from filing date, non-extendable. Trademark, 10 years, renewable for another 10 years indefinitely. Copyright, it depends, but generally 50 years. Okay, non-extendable as well. Okay, patent, kailangan i-register saan? Sa Bureau of Patents, sa IPO. For trademark, sa Bureau of Trademarks, sa IPO. Copyright, protected from moment of creation, no need for registration, pero pwede mo pa rin ipa-register sa National Library Office or sa IPO. Pero optional lang yun. Okay? Sige. So, lastly, sige, practical application tayo to test kung naintindihan nyo ba yung distinction ng patent, copyright, tsaka trademark. Gawin natin example ito. So, ang makakuha ng sagot, bibigyan ni Sir Rex ng ganyan. Hindi, joke lang. Okay. So, ang makakuha ng mga tanong dyan, ayan. So, gamitin natin example ang iPhone. Okay. So, sa iPhone, alin dyan yung mga subject ng copyright? Sige. Kapag na, alam mo, si iPhone, si Apple, gusto niyang ipa-copyright yung portion ng kanyang ano, portion ng kanyang creation. Alin dyan yung pwede maging subject ng copyright? Okay. Tignan natin kung may sasagot. O baka walang sumagot. Ayun yun ang iPhone. Wala. Sumasagot. Oh, sabi ni Ian, operating system. Okay. Correct. That's correct. What else? Yung form ng phone? Is it copyrightable? Copyright ha? Copyright. Okay. So tama na doon si Ian Henrich sa operating system. Okay. Sa design daw, sabi ni Arficed. Okay. So reveal na natin yung for copyright. So for copyright, pwedeng ipa-copyright yung programs. Yung operating system, pati yung apps. Okay? Tama. Sa honey. How about for trademark? Alin dyan yung pwedeng ipa-trademark? Ayan na, lumabas na. Yung logos, itong Apple, pati yung wordmarks. So, pwede. How about for patent? Alin yung pwedeng ipa-patent ni, yung may kagat daw, sabi ni Rina. Alin yung may kagat dyan? Okay. Alin dyan kay iPhone yung pwedeng i-subject ng patent? Okay. Okay, yung design. Nakita na natin yung design. Else? Camera function. Ba? Nakinig to si ano ha? Ian Henrich de Leon. Yan, very good. What else? What do you think? Aside from camera. That's correct. Yung camera ni iPhone, it's distinctive, no? Talagang mas ano siya. If you compare it with other brands, talagang ano rin, may edge. So aside from camera, what do you think? What else can be the subject of patent? Ana? Sirit na? Okay. Sige. So aside from camera, you can also apply for patent for Siri. Yes, correct. You can also apply for patent for fingerprint recognition, facial recognition. Yan, pwede rin si Siri. Okay? Sige. So that ends our discussion for intellectual property law. Thank you so much for bearing with me tonight. Okay, sige. If you have any questions, do you have any questions? Thank you so much.